Can't you make me sleep? Na shanach idi a knasta, ban a winta ma wahir, gzeginchir skelta kushtinis ichistin. Nis mena dinne beheriger viskum, the laurshige krianas go hussel, fi aver arse gz lechula. Bent hens brücke vi eke, na rin saltartum, ach fi shin the fear wuntarum, har wuntar I beheri. Angus na scéalta bhí aici, na bhí rí, thrád a rá, in éidin, a bhaile hárta ar grúpa buchilí, agus a dagra iad mar hochaí. Ad ag an dóibh an lithe héin a rachtáil, agus a gineirí héin a cheapa. Bine mi chéad spdécha, ar chóir buchilí an wacha. Lanada, Sally, you take her Lianu and Ots Lekna Laholus. Solus of Eads are Solus Graine and Solus Galley. Honishiga Hansilier, we in the Gran, exit Doracha, nice spader, we wehne. Niakshi spader and Ashen Reeve, expa alling lay. Hulashi Kush came. Agus hig si gra dinnig cinti tíocht chicin níos an loch. Bhí sé ar falcha cinti gra míru tól vár a tí a tás bántate, agus gra páis uasach I cinti le fólingtín sin ag dinnig cinti. Níar vádate a fánacht, guach si mácó, go tríl, go tórsach tí avrén a cailé. Bhí a chán crum aige, agus cum a mór vróin ar. Dainin nóra é. Mac wyr I fi an, agus fi seg yn ora, gras y tril yn y enr, chwn y ffosio.
House with the creatures of my imagination, and to see myself going into the perils that were pictured there. This was my way with every book that was read to me, with every picture I saw, with every story or song that I heard. I saw myself doing or suffering all the things that were dared or suffered in the book.
Or shade of a while ya, or shade of a while ya, or shade of a while ya, and this shade chat on Sarah. Shade of a van merlamer, bear crack to vet in aver. Duga bra is slave merlak is who deal to leshna galiv. Oh, shade of a while ya, oh, shade of a while ya, oh, shade of a while ya, and this shade chat on Sarah. Grown you may like chucked her soul, or a gram to let my garden. Gale feeding, no gone spanny, is curfew to her gallop. Or shade of a walia, or shade of a walia, or shade of a walia, and is her chucked on Sarah.
There has been nothing more terrible in Irish history than the failure of the last generation. Other generations have failed, but they've failed nobly, or failing ignobly. Some man among them has redeemed them from infamy by the splendor of his protest. But the failure of the last generation has been mean and shameful, and no man has arisen from it to say or do a splendid thing in virtue of which it shall be forgiven. The whole episode is squalid. It will remain the one sickening chapter in a story which, gallant or sorrowful, has everywhere else some exaltation of pride. If nationality be regarded as the sum of the facts, spiritual and intellectual, which mark off one nation from another, and freedom as the condition which allows those facts full scope and development, it will be seen that both the spiritual and intellectual fact, nationality, and the physical condition, freedom, enter into a proper definition of independence or nationhood. Freedom is a condition which can be lost and won and lost again. Nationality is a life which, if once lost, can never be recovered. A nation is a stubborn thing, very hard to kill, but a dead nation does not come back to life any more than a dead man. There will never again be a Ligurian nation, nor an Aztec nation, nor a Cornish nation. Irish nationality is an ancient spiritual tradition, and the Irish nation could not die as long as that tradition lived in the heart of one faithful man or woman. But had the last repositor of the Gaelic tradition, the last unconquered Gael, died, the Irish nation was no more. Any free state that might thereafter be erected in Ireland, whatever it might call itself, would certainly not be the historic Irish nation. A soulless thing cannot teach, but it can destroy. A machine cannot make men, but it can break men. One of the most terrible things about the English education system in Ireland is its ruthlessness. I know no image for that ruthlessness in the natural order. The ruthlessness of a wild beast has in it a certain mercy, it slays. It has in it a certain grandeur of animal force. But this ruthlessness is literally without pity and without passion. It's cold and mechanical, like the ruthlessness of an immensely powerful engine. A machine vast and complicated, it grinds night and day. It obeys immutable and predetermined laws. It is as devoid of understanding, of sympathy, of imagination, as is any other piece of machinery that performs an appointed task. Into it is fed all the raw human material of Ireland. It seizes upon it inexorably and rends and compresses and remolds, and what it cannot refashion, it ejects, a bruised and shapeless thing. There are no ideas here, no love of beauty, no love of books, no love of knowledge, no heroic inspiration. And there is no room for such things, either on earth or in the heavens, for the earth is cumbered and the heavens are darkened by the monstrous bulk of the program.
Gohulgus earning our glue, Maran Rayaskal is gaily a hille. Tashi Gohulgus earning the funtok the aide. Tashi Gohulgus earning a funtok on the fade, a gusmra, gulio, our nanimnacha. Tashi Gohulgus earning the funtok on tradition, a tala hachrohu, a gusle boon in aide. On tradition, ridderul, gaun wacha. Marav egana, in aalocht a macnachta. An tár tradisiún go chuchollainn is far saol ghear le honóir na saol fada le náire. An tradisiún úsach na fianna, an tradisiún chístúil go chollam cille. Scotúr humsach me sé éasca an bhela se úsáid chun buchilí agus cailíní éirinacha a bhúine, an is go me siad króga agus nebh lehlasach, onric agus gláin. Tam kintie nach mei ein vela elle abelt a grie a chori na a gud saulichte a wuskels inter a rudi lechule se schlichene. Sheen is schnechte. Eier a revniv. Loch an nocht na réalta. Cuing ar asif, linse in a lecaif, brónach lum an saol. Ach a bháthir, bháil bháinla, trúa an seanúir críanna. Bocht náras, a bhasca a stábla. Manúr is talamh an dídan. Fuair an oíche, trúa an líon, lom mo chás a leaba. Tuirgan gaoiche, cruat an gíomhre, olc do áilse a leana. Ceol sna phláis ag cór na nangal, stoc is píb is cláiseach, glór an neua a gáil a gáinsic. Is a mulla chríist an tárdraí.
Tá cuaireachta de fóig, tá
Achar frí fósnum e bógav na man na malsam a gorp. Vig na rusk glas an lasar sin eid chlúis de múm fach bán da leha maroon an teig wil maroon ni fiú eid tangwalad nach trú an bál sin e vig na glas.
When we are old, those of us who live to be old, we shall tell our grandchildren of the Christmas of 1915 as the second Christmas which saw the nations at war for the freedom of the seas, as the last Christmas, it may be, which saw Ireland, the gate of the seas, in the keeping of the English. The last 16 months have been the most glorious in the history of Europe. Heroism has come back to the earth. On whichever side the men who rule the peoples have marshalled them, whether with England to uphold her tyranny of the seas, or with Germany to break that tyranny, the people themselves have gone into battle because to each the old voice that speaks out of the soil of a nation has spoken anew. Each fights for the fatherland. It's policy that moves governments. It is patriotism that stirs the peoples. It's good for the world that such things should be done. The old heart of the earth needed to be warmed with the red wine of the battlefields. Such august homage was never before offered to God as this, the homage of millions of lives given gladly for love of country. War is a terrible thing, and this is the most terrible of wars. But this war is not more terrible than the evils which it will end or help to end. It is not more terrible than the exploitation of the English masses by cruel plutocrats. It is not more terrible than the infidelity of the French masses to their old spiritual ideals. It is not more terrible than the enslavement of the Poles by Russia, than the enslavements of the Irish by England. War is a terrible thing, but war is not an evil thing. It is the things that make war necessary that are evil. The tyrannies that wars break, the lying formulae that wars overthrow, the hypocrisies that wars strip naked are evil. Many people in Ireland dread war because they do not know it. Ireland has not known the exhilaration of war for over 100 years. Yet who will say that she has known the blessings of peace? When war comes to Ireland, she must welcome it as she would welcome the angel of God. And she will.
The Mosma Cortan Ara or Chapadar Roshans Eloan Marialer and Vertirum.
The idea of using a blanket covered in cut grass was very clever. It's something straight out of, you know, World War II stories, which many of them had read and studied.
The screen club Macortan and Rod Jerry Hadochinum now. Listen here now. This is for Ireland. This isn't to get out and have a good time around the country.
Agus mahúl ragla gastáning Da chúlas da cheol A vinni na binni Is da chúnas machlúas ragla gaglishing Flashes the veil A vílse na mílse Is chrúas machrí ragla ma vílse Da galas mahúl Smachluas gahunas, smachluas da hunas, da chruas machri, smavien da wuchas, da hugas machul, eren ashling a chumas, seren road sharom, mai da hugas, da hugas machnush, eren road sharom, eren gniv shahim. Saren Moss the Yod.
Not go back to your sagas will come to you again in a new guise. For they are terrible, immortal things, not capable of being put down by respectable society or by political economy. The old truths will find new mouths, the old sorrows and ecstasies, new interpretation. Beauty is the garment of truth. Or perhaps we should put it that beauty is the substance in which truth bodies itself forth. And then we can say that beauty, like matter, is indestructible, however it may. Of the world hath made me sad, this beauty that will pass. Sometimes My heart hath shaken with great joy to see a leaping squirrel in a tree, or a red ladybird upon a stalk, or little rabbits in a field at evening lit by the slanting sun, or some green hill where shadows drifted by, some quiet hill where mountainy men had sown and soon would reap near to the gate of heaven. Or children with bare feet upon the sands of some ebbed sea, or playing on the streets of little towns in Connacht, things young and happy. And then my heart. Pass and change, will die and be no more. Things bright and green, things young and happy, and I have gone upon my way. This is a place of peace, sacred to the dead, where men should speak with all charity and all restraint. But I hold it a Christian thing, as O'Donovan Rossa held it, to hate evil, to hate untruth, to hate oppression, and by hating them, to strive to overthrow them. Our foes are strong and wise and wary. But strong and wise and wary as they are, they cannot undo the miracles of God who ripen in the hearts of young men. Rulers and defenders of realms had need to be wary if they would guard against such processes. Life springs from death, and from the graves of patriot men and women spring living nations. The defenders of this realm have worked well in secret and in the open. They think that they have pacified Ireland. They think that they have pacified half of us and intimidated the other half. They think that they have foreseen everything, think that they have provided against everything. But the fools, the fools, the fools. They have left us our Fenian dead. And while Ireland holds these graves, Ireland unfree shall never be at peace.
Every ucham, quack metaltalum hain. Dinid ar mochleeks galena. Ishasa in the ainer ar ardonus kin slua intachdini. Agis tiguham, grashin a boss or in shin, erwile, kush or mochikins. Kush na haiden, na kushele. Fi come a soon shacher. A broadul, agis ahasach. Gardu a chan agus iver ra reingan siems air. Is gwynam grogus fi dair a scornach bán, lom agus an chrúig ar a chlóred an a chrúi ag an lí mar agus na nés a fi dair a gaminig ar an bár gamán eichta. Frahas mairan chovínehe is me fechan sin nus air. Mairan a chua niart seachas a ligi.
Thank you.
do not grudge them. Lord, I do not grudge my two strong sons that I have seen go out to break their strength and die. They and a few in bloody protest for a glorious thing. They shall be spoken of among their people. The generations shall remember them and call them blessed. But I will speak their names to my own heart in the long nights. The little names that were familiar once round my dead hearth. Lord, thou art hard on mothers. We suffer in their coming and their going. And though I grudge them not, I weary of the long sorrow. And yet I have my joy. My sons were faithful, and they fought. I am come of the seed of the people that sorrow, that have no treasure but hope, no riches laid up but a memory of an ancient glory. My mother bore me in bondage. In bondage my mother was born. I am of the blood of serfs. The children with whom I've played, the men and women with whom I've eaten, have had masters over them, have been under the lash of masters. And though gentle, have served churls. The hands that have touched mine, the dear hands whose touch is familiar to me, have worn shameful manacles, have been bitten at the wrist by manacles, have grown hard with the manacles and the task work of strangers. I am flesh of these lowly. I am bone of their bone. I that have never submitted, I that have a soul greater than the souls of my people's master. I that have a vision and prophecy and the gift of fiery speech. I that have spoken with God on the top of his holy hill. And because I am of the people, I understand the people. I'm sorrowful with their sorrow. I'm hungry with their desire. My heart has been heavy with the grief of mothers. My eyes have been wet with the tears of children. I have yearned with old, wistful men and laughed or cursed with young men. Their shame is my shame, and I have reddened for it. Reddened for that they have served, they who should be free. Reddened for those that have gone in want while others been full. Reddened for that they have walked in fear of lawyers and of jailers with their writs of summons and their handcuffs. Men, mean and cruel. I could have borne stripes on my body rather than this shame of my people. And now I speak, being full of vision. I speak to my people, and I speak in my people's name to the masters of my people. I say to my people that they are holy, that they are august despite their chains, that they are greater than those that hold them, and stronger and purer, and that they have but need of courage and to call on the name of their God, God the unforgetting, the dear God that loves the peoples for whom he died naked, suffering shame. And I say to my people's masters, beware. Beware of the thing that is coming. Beware of the risen people who shall take what ye would not give. Did ye think to conquer the people? Or that law is stronger than life and than men's desire to be free? We will try it out with you. ye that have harried and held, ye that have bullied and bribed, tyrants, hypocrites, liars. I admit that I was Commandant General Commanding in Chief of the forces of the Irish Republic, which have been acting against you for the past week, and that I was President of the Provisional Government. I stand over all my acts and words done or spoken in these capacities. When I was a child of 10, I went down on my bare knees by my bedside one night and promised God that I should devote my life to an effort to free my country. I have kept that promise. For among all earthly things, as a boy and as a man, I have worked for Irish freedom. I have helped to organize, to arm, to train, and to discipline my fellow countrymen to the sole end that when the time came, they might fight for Irish freedom. The time, as it seemed to me, did come, and we went into the fight. I'm glad we did. We seem to have lost. We have not lost. To refuse to fight would have been to lose. To fight is to win. We have kept faith with the past and handed a tradition to the future. And how my heart yearns to you all. I will call to you in my heart at the last moment. Your son.
Sonin. Tashi the Cleacharum. Terawet Katin Tea, the mini green the side, Shugonian. Terawet Sonin. Tarn the Farigi Freyachte, Katin Tea and Tullish. Terawet Onin in Nain. Nietami Detacht. Banachdad Warin. Mavin in me, the Banachdad. A Warin Machri. Farigi Freyachte, Katin Tea and Mansion, the Hour Gondi. Link Sheikh Yan Shear, Holy Nuwad, Agus Hersha Osnath. Clinu Gulm Ra unto Night Wag Nahud, Gulm War, the Queen of Pashti, Yoni Nimi, Sakhar the Fondo.
My gift to you hath been the gift of sorrow, my one return for your rich gifts to me, your gift of life, your gift of love and pity, your gift of sanity, your gift of faith. For who hath had such faith as yours since the old time, and what were my poor faith without your strong belief to found upon? For all these precious things, my gift to you is sorrow. I have seen your dear face line, your face soft to my touch, familiar to my hands and to my lips since I was little. I have seen how you have battled with your tears for me, and with a proud, glad look, although your heart was breaking. O mother, for you know me, you must have known when I was silent that some strange thing within me kept me dumb. Some strange, deep thing, when I should shout my love. I have sobbed in secret for that reserve which yet I could not master. I would have brought you royal gifts, and I have brought you tears and sorrow. And yet it may be that I have brought you something else besides. The memory of my deed and of my name, a splendid thing that shall not pass away. When men speak of me in praise or in dispraise, you will not heed, but treasure your own memory of your first son. I speak that I'm only a fool. A fool that has loved his folly, yea, more than the wise men their books or their counting houses, or their quiet homes or their fame in men's mouths. A fool that in all his days hath done never a prudent thing, never hath counted the cost, nor recked if another reaped the fruit of his mighty sowing, content to scatter the seed. A fool that is unrepentant, and that soon at the end of all shall laugh in his lonely heart as the ripe ears fall to the reaping hooks and the poor are filled that were empty, though he go hungry. I have squandered the splendid years that the Lord God gave my youth in attempting impossible things, deeming them alone worth the toil. Was it folly or grace? Not men shall judge me, but God. I've squandered the splendid years, and Lord, if I had the years, I would squander them over again. I fling them from me, for this I have heard in my heart, that a man shall scatter, not hoard, shall not bargain or huckster with God. Or was it a jest of Christ's, and is my sin before men to have taken him at his word? The lawyers have sat in council, the men with keen, long faces, and said, this man is a fool, and others have said, he blasphemeth. And the wise have pitied the fool that hath striven to give a life in the world of time and space among the bulks of actual things to a dream that was dreamed in the heart and that only the heart could hold. O wise men, riddle me this. What if the dream come true? What if the dream come true and the millions unborn shall dwell in the house I shaped in my heart, the noble house of my thought? Lord, I've staked my soul. I've staked the lives of my kin on the truth of thy dreadful word. Do not remember my failures, but remember this, my faith. And so I speak, yea, ere my hot youth pass, I speak to my people and say, ye shall be as foolish as I, ye shall scatter, not save. Ye shall venture your all, lest ye lose what is more than all. Ye shall call for a miracle, taking Christ at his word, and for this I will answer. O people, answer here.
Sinna mé nach caiach réire, má a gláir mé rug chu chulín croge, má a gláir má chan féin í le bhhar, mu sé éir sinna mé nach caiach réire.
Níor cruinniú lomsa óir, an chúd a phrílam dóig, san ghrád a fuaras blán, ma híl de hérig. Tá anús na de glóir, Ní ágad a mhóig, lumsa a hías leor, ach manam a grí linif.
Gan by Lergus Lehagan Heel and Tile Yagas and Seal, a gutting tree hool, a couple, and Tatan Jehogan Annacht, agus knúsach mór fáisnéis le fáil ar ar sí vidilín is fid le te chuig ar sí vidilín agus brennú siir ar do chiúil a chéin. Sa tante a leir an chasúr héis nó ógrisa ar an crisis.
Tá me buíach go nehí a hé an tróin a nehí sé. Hokil is fech dul nis fuju, le nis mo torhi e bunchlish.
That's my just session. Te buita ma van hen, ni lina bi, gwyl me kusuf nuk le elesh, no lehi na mara tamra le John, og sto sura og gubari jiwa.
John agus Tommy McCardle.
A sura og gubari me nis fuju na.
Anam noch, te kedin eg lahwari shani ar TG Cahar.